Now for the show that's truly too hot to handle. It's The Melting Pat, and it starts right now.
You're listening to The Melting Pat. Here's your host, Pat Johnson.
Well, thank you, Jerome. Hello, my friends, and welcome to the show, The Melting Pat, the Next Level Network. Hope you're well. I am exhausted, as always. It's been hot, and, you know, it's tough to sleep when it's hot. It happens. We have air conditioning, don't worry. But, you know, then the kid is in a different place, and he's not comfortable. So it's been something, man and woman, ladies and gentlemen. It's been something. I'm not built for this. I'm telling you. Oh, gosh. All right, we need to get to a place with central air, I think. That's what rich people had, right? So we need that. We do. It's going to be great. Or not. Or we're just going to melt. I don't know. That would make sense for the show, that this could be the last one. No. It's going to be fine. We're all going to be great. Hope you're well. Today, I'll tell you about our trip to New York. I will talk to you about housing developments in the middle of nowhere, which I think I touched on about a month ago. But we've seen it again. And I want to talk about it some more, if that's okay with you. I'll talk about a movie idea we came up with in the car, or maybe a real crime, an idea for a real crime for someone to commit. I think that could be fun. Not me, but someone who is good at crime could do that. So let me know if you follow through with this one. You can let me know privately. I'm no snitch. I am no snitch. I will not turn you in, especially if you follow through with this silly idea we came up with. And the back half of the show will be... we got a couple of updates from last week with the movie scores, and then our question, so we'll play a couple of those, and then our question was, which movie you've never seen makes people go, you've never seen that? And so I decided we're going to play some clips from those scores as well. Why not? Yeah, last week's episode was one of the most fun to put together, first of all. And I've never gotten, not never, I haven't gotten that much feedback about an episode in a very long time. So thank you very much for that. I'm glad you enjoyed it. And anytime you got a movie score, a TV score, we might do a video game one. I don't know. Let me know. And it'd be easier going forward if we just have to plug in one or two as opposed to 12 or 20. All right. So, so if you have any movie scores, doesn't have to be your favorite, just one you like. Maybe one you listen to, or one that you saw the movie on TV and went, oh, that's pretty cool. Send that over everywhere at The Melting Pat, and we'll try to get that in for you. All right? All right. So all of that to say, there's the menu for the show. But the first thing, there you go. Offspring. I don't know where that came from either. What I'm trying to tell you is we have new music from our dear friends, Cherie Amour. And Trey, you were supposed to come back. You were supposed to come on the show in the summer. Not that I would have had time to do it. But now I guess, since your new EP is coming out in October, you'd have to come back and talk baseball playoffs, and then talk about whatever else that we would talk about when you came back to the show. All right, so Trey, get your ass back here. And in the meantime, we're going to play a new song. Cherie Amour Band, I think, is their website.com. I'm going to check it right now because I don't want to let you down here. CherieAmourBand.com. That is right. That's CHERIEAMOUR Band, BAND.com for more from them. This song, by the way, is not safe for work. It is on their upcoming EP, Some Songs. That's coming out October 20, courtesy Equal Vision Records. There we go. We got everything. We're good. We're doing great. So here it is. Our dear friends, Cherie Amour. The song is 702. It's The Melting Pat. We're coming right back.
Things went down. You say that you want this, But you gotta be honest. You give me love, you give me hell, but it's all good. I wish you well. I just wanna be with you. You don't know what love is, baby. Let me show you. I just wanna be with you. Baby, won't you come close? Try to see those pretty blues. Thinking of the time we spent. Remember that time we went to Venice Beach, the Hennessy. Had me all slurring speech. We rolled the tree before we hit the main event. Guess you could say I was bent. And baby, I might just be late on my rent. But never was late for you, baby. You said you would love me too. In the valley in view, I just knew things were gonna be better. Thought our spirits were bonded together. I was your king and you were my Coretta. But how did this all come untethered? I'm missing you, boo. Got letters from you on my dresser.
Baby, I'm so fucking disappointed in you. I trusted you.
There we go, our friends, Cherie Amour, 702, their latest, their upcoming EP, Some Songs EP, coming out October 20 on Equal Vision Records, CherieAmourBand.com for more from them. Trey, come on back, man. Come on back. See, October 20, that's right in the middle of playoff time. Let me see, MLB playoff schedule. We're going to look this up. We're going to look this up right now and see where we would be schedule-wise. To talk about that, we should be in the league championship series, correct? If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we would be. So that would come out on a day when the league championship series would be played. Potentially two games, like both of them. All right, great. So come on back, Trey, sometime within in that frame there. We could talk the album, talk playoffs, talk whatever you want. And then, yeah, we'll go from there. Or just come back in November like you did last year. And we'll talk about the end of the year and all the wrap-up things and maybe get into basketball if you want. I don't know. But let's do that. All right? Now I'm planning an interview for the show that I've not talked to the guest about. But no, he and I talked about it coming back on. So what better time to do it than when an EP comes out? Right? Right? All right. Again, CherieAmourBand.com. Big fan. I love those dudes. They're so good and so much fun. All right. So go check them out. Tell them I sent you. And at least one of them will go, yeah, that guy. The rest of them will go, I don't know who that is, and move on with their day, just like we're going to do right now. All right, so we went to New York this weekend, last weekend, I should say. My newest nephew got baptized, so we went up there for the night. And I got to say, I'm thankful to my smoking hot wife for doing the surrogacy for many reasons. But you know, if she didn't do that, she wouldn't have gotten a car, and then we wouldn't have been able to go. So it's been great. It's been awesome. I got to see some doctors and get on that and get myself to doing things. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. Just thanks a lot to my smoking hot wife for doing the thing. So we go up there, and it's like a four-hour drive. So we stop halfway in both directions at the same place at the Hickory Run Service Plaza. And it's a big thing. You got food in there. You got a 7-Eleven for your conveniences. And the kid loved the water fountains. So, yeah, we just, I guess she, because I went to the bathroom or went to do something, And then I came back and he was playing with water fountains. So she showed him that. So he's pressing. They're going up. He's like, ah, it's great. Again, he's two. So, you know, these things will entertain him for a while. And then they have like little massage chairs where you can also charge your phone. So if you give the chair money, this sounds dumb, but if you give the chair money for a massage for it to go for however many minutes, you can also charge your phone in that time. But it's not a free, it's not a free charge your phone thing. Like you have to do the massage to do it, to charge your phone, which is actually kind of genius. I mean, it's messed up. Like, why do I have to pay to charge my phone? But, you know, charge your phone, I guess. You know, charge your phone and you don't have to worry about it. But anyway, I like obsessively charge my phone. So, like when my battery gets below, I don't know, 72%, I'm like, oh, got to plug it in. I know that's probably bad for the battery, but I mean, I run my phones into the ground, if we're being real. You know, I don't get a new phone until my phone literally stops working. And so it'll be a bit. So anyway, we go up there. We had a nice time. We got up there Saturday night, stayed in a little hotel there, hung out with the nieces and nephews. And then, you know, mass was mass, and the kid lasted longer than I thought he would. And so Jill took him out. I was, you know, we were like up front because, again, our the little guy, the newest guy, was the star of the show. And I guess I'm, you know, part of that in some way. And so I'm up front. We're front and center, front row, and not really center, but... So Jill took him out. She said they went outside for a while. They did a lap around the church and then came back to the back of the church. And there were some women back there who, somewhat, you know, old church ladies, right? And they took to the kid immediately because old ladies like taking, like, I don't know, playing with the kids, I guess. I don't know. so they were doing that. The mass was mass and everybody was cool, right? So it went, I think, as well as it could have. As well as it could have. Yeah. It could have been worse. I mean, the kid freaked out, of course, because you got to sit still, and he's not too good at that because he's two. And, you know, I think it went well. All things considered, I think it went okay. And then he ran around with his cousins and then, you know, got in the car, fell asleep, woke up at the service plaza again on the way back, played with the water fountains, ran around 7-Eleven, and then that was it. And it was, I will say, he got very mad when the sun was in his eyes, when we were entering New York and then coming home, like the last stretch coming home, the sun was in his eyes and he was getting very upset about that. But other than that, he was really good in the car and really good, like overall, really good, which was awesome. So, solid time. And I just, you know, I'm thankful for my smoking hot wife again for many reasons, but especially because if she didn't do the surrogacy, she wouldn't have the car. We wouldn't be able to go. And then this show would be more boring. So there you go. Or I'd have more bus stories, I guess. I don't know. But that was that. It was a solid time. Good time to see. Good seeing everybody. It was a solid solid trip. And I will say, let's. How do we transition here? Well, I guess first we do the little pat peeve. And then we'll do the idea we came up with while we're going up there. So I mentioned a couple months ago that we saw like a development, a housing development that was like right on an interstate, right on the highway. And we're like, wow, that sucks if you're a kid and your mom or dad doesn't have, or whoever doesn't have a car because there's nothing here. And I'm like, wow, yeah, that does suck. That's terrible. So we're driving up the turnpike and we see several of these little developments, like brand new houses. They all look the same. You know, quickly went up. Somebody, you know, developer buys the land, builds the same house six or seven times and pays or charges, you know, $500,000 or whatever. So like the location, I guess the location, if that's where you want to be, it works out. But I'm just thinking, cause like it's right off the turnpike. So like, yeah, you're close to a thing, but then you look around in the immediate vicinity and there's nothing. It's just trees and then road and then some more trees, and that's it. And I'm just thinking, like, first of all, why the hell would you, like, I find my neighborhood too noisy. Like, and I don't live downtown, right? But I find my neighborhood with all the hustle and bustle and nonsense to be annoying, right? Not so bad that I want, well, never mind. But why would you want to live right near the turnpike? Like, how do you handle all that stuff? And then, you know, you pay all that money and then there's nothing there, right? So like, Well, all right. I assume if you live there that you have a car and that you will drive to wherever you have to go, right? But let's say, for the sake of argument, your kid gets out of school at 2. He gets dropped off by the bus or whoever at, say, 2:30, and you work till 5. You're not home till 5:45-ish, right? Let's say that. And the kid's 12, so he can't drive. And I'm guessing there's no transit system in that area. And maybe there is, I don't know. But let's roll with this theory that there isn't. So this kid's sitting there, oh, I'm 12, it's 2:30, or let's say it's 3:15, I'm done with all my stuff that I had to do, schoolwork and otherwise, and oh, I want to go somewhere. Oh, mom doesn't get home for 2.5 hours, so, or dad, or whoever. The person with the car doesn't get home for 2.5 hours, so I can't go to my friend's house, or like, hey, we want to go and do this. Well, we can't do that, because this house is next to nothing. I mean, other houses, sure, like you go play with the neighborhood kids, but like if you don't know them or if they're older, younger, whatever, right? Like you're, it's not a, what I'm saying is, hold on, my ears are ringing like crazy. One second. Sorry, my next fan was ringing like crazy. I don't know what happened there. I don't know if that came through. It probably did. Sorry. That I don't know. That happens ever so often. The next fan will kind of get a high-pitched sound. So I turned it off. It's fine. Anyway, what I mean to say is the houses, like, it's cool, man. You got a place to live and that's great, but you're right off the turnpike and that's got to suck. And then like your kid's 12, can't drive. Say your friend lives, I don't know, somewhere not in the immediate neighborhood. So you can't hang out until you're done work. And then it's dinner time and then, you know, getting close to bedtime. So, well, I just... I don't know. Like, I wouldn't want to live right off the turnpike anyway. And then you add in some other stuff like, oh, like if I'm not here or like, say, if, you know, whatever, the person with the car, whoever isn't here, then we can't go anywhere. The kid is stuck there. The kid is trapped because there's nothing to really walk to go have fun and do. There's no like, oh, let's go to the pizza place. Well, that's 4 miles away. We got to drive there. And it's just like the, I don't know, I guess it's a very American thing, right? Dependence on cars. Like, you can't just take a whatever everywhere. You can't walk everywhere. You can't take a bus conveniently everywhere like you could do in another country. But it just, I don't know, that maybe it's because I don't drive and that's why it kind of strikes a different chord with me. But I just, these houses that like, they're in the middle of nothing. Like there's just nothing there, nothing around. And it's like, oh, I want to go, like say my car breaks down somewhere. Oh, I guess I can't go anywhere. I guess that, well, that sucks. There's nothing around. Can't jump on the bus. Can't go to the train. Nowhere near it. It's just really weird that, number one, I'm certain these houses cost $500,000 or more to live in. So you got to spend all that money to live right off the turnpike, which has to be terrible. So I tell you, anybody listening to this, do you live on or around the turnpike or a major highway where, like, the house, like, you can see the highway from your place? That's what I mean. Like close enough where you can look out the window or walk outside and see it and or be there to where like you're right. Like if you say, hey, I'm right off this, right off the turnpike, right off whatever. Let me know. I want to know what the situation is over there, because from where I'm sitting and from where I was sitting when we were going up there, it seems like a terrible place to live just on many levels. And so I'd like to know how that really is. If anybody knows, if anybody lives out there, themeltingpat.com, reach out. Sorry, that's the melting pat. There we go. Let me know, because it sounds like a terrible place to live, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's a hidden gem or something, or some other fun thing there, like some other good reason to live there. Let me know what's up, all right? But like from where I sit now, it just seems like a terrible place to live. I just think it just looks... I don't know. Not good. Not good. Not a fan. Mm-mm. Couldn't be me. Couldn't be me. So, yeah, just a little thing that bugged me. How, like, because, like, these bugged both of us, really. Because, like, these houses are next to nothing. They're in the middle of nowhere. And if you don't have reliable transportation, or if your transportation is out of commission for any length of time, you're literally trapped in your house. From where we sat, where we could see and try to figure out what the lay of the land was, it seems like you would literally be trapped in your house, in your neighborhood, if you didn't have a car that was working or whatever. So maybe I'm wrong. Let me know. And we can sort this out. But until then, thumbs down on living right off the turnpike, at least for me. All right, there you go. So let's do a fun thing real quick, and then we'll get to the meat of the show, the main event of the show, if you will. We thought about this on the way up. I can't remember why this came up. Maybe we saw a billboard of something, like it was something about employers that don't pay well. And I'm like, man, wouldn't it be something if you could inconvenience those businesses as a way to get back at them for not paying their employees well? So you think like big box stores, fast food places, the big box hardware store. Well, yeah, big boxes, meaning like, I'm not going to mention the names, but you know what? You get it. You get it, right? The big box stores, the one-stop shop places. And I'm not talking about mom and pop stores or local places. We're not talking about those. I'm talking about the big places where the owners, the whoever, they make the money and the employees don't get paid well. That's what I mean. So I don't know how we came across this, but the crime would be like something, it's not a serious crime, not something you're going to get arrested for. Well, you probably will, but it's not a crime they're going to throw the book at you over. Stealing register tape. So just take the roll, and we're like, oh, like, what do you do? Go to the back and steal all the rolls, and they go, oh, we got to change the register tape. Oh, there's none left in here. What the hell? No. Like, and that was the first thing. Like, go and steal it from the back or whatever, and then they have none left. But I think the funnier play would be, we came on this one, the funniest play would be if you take the roll from the register. Now, logistically, we haven't worked out how you would do this without being caught. And I know there are some wrinkles here, but the idea is you steal the roll of register tape from the actual register. So when they go, so like you wait for them to leave their station or turn around and you quickly open the thing, because all you got to do is press a little button and the top of the register tape dispenser pops up. You can take it right out and then, you know, click it back down and you're all good. Just a little inconvenience for the store. And I'm like, oh man, that'd be so good. So you take the roll from the register and you run away. Somehow you don't get caught. And I thought about the idea of like going back to the same place every year on the same date to take register tape, because then it's like, oh man, or like you hit several stores on the same day. So it's like, oh, it's, you know, September 7th. Here comes that guy to steal the stuff. And like, oh, we gotta watch out. It's like Halloween, except you're disrupting business, right? So you're not murdering anyone. You're just like, oh, here comes that guy. So you gotta like keep your eyes on the register and make sure they don't get the tape. And then, you know, you hear a noise behind you and you go, oh, and you turn around and the thing's open and it's gone. You're like, no. So this could be fun if you do this both as a real crime and or a movie. And then like you have them all the roles in a storage unit. And like when they catch you, you take them there. It's like, you know, again, it's like a serial killer movie, except you're not hiding bodies. You're hiding rolls of register tape from random restaurants and businesses. And you say you get arrested. This is the end of the movie. You get arrested and they take you. And they're like, all right, where is it? Where is it? And you take them to a storage locker and it's just floor to ceiling boxes of stolen register tape over the years. Labeled by restaurant or establishment, labeled by business. So like you have your one box here of the food place and the hardware store and all that. And you get not mentioning company names on purpose, by the way. Like I said, it's like Halloween, except you're disrupting business. You're disrupting businesses that don't pay their employees well. That's what you're doing. And I think we think it could be great. We could be a great, either a great movie or a great real crime to commit. So, you know, try that either way and let me know if you committed the crime and got away with it. Again, I'm no snitch. Should I be advocating this on the show? Nobody really cares. Nobody important is going to listen and go, nobody who could levy consequences against me will hear this and go, oh, we got to do this. But if you do the crime part of it, I had nothing to do with it. You acted on your own, and I disavow your actions. But if you make a movie out of it, I want credit, or like a series, a web short or something. I want credit for that part. But if you do the crime, I don't know who you are. So there you go. But yeah, just a little thing to disrupt an employer that doesn't pay their employees very well. And I think it could be great. We thought about this. You know, look, it's a long time in the car, so they can't all be winners. But we thought this would be fun. So if anybody wants to make this movie, let me know. And we'll try to iron out some details. And we'll go from there. All right? All right. So just a little fun. I got a little peeved about houses in the middle of nowhere. So I figure let's give you an idea that we came up with while driving through these places with the houses in the middle of nowhere and the trees and the, you know, people being stupid and not paying attention to the road. And then we came up with this idea and we thought it was fun. Did we miss on this one? Is that not great? Or do you, here's a better thing. Do you have a way to improve this idea and make this a little more airtight? Because I know there are some holes. There are some holes in this story, in this logic here of how you would do it. But if you have an idea of how to steal register tape from the registers of these businesses without getting caught, and then you become notorious for some reason, maybe it'll work. Maybe you do it in one town. So, like, say the town has the restaurant, the hardware store, and the big box store. Why they would all be in one town? Why wouldn't they just have the one? I don't know. But let's say that. Let's put it there. Like, you're in one location, and every year you go back and you steal register. Maybe you go back several times a day, and you steal it from there. And they're like, he struck again. And or like you hit one in the morning, and then one at lunchtime, and then one at night. And they go, he's back again, or she, or whoever. And maybe that can work that way. All right? No? Any of this resonating with anybody? We thought it was funny. Maybe I should have recorded this in the car, and then it would still have been funnier. I don't know. Would have been. I don't know. But we have some updates from our question from last week, and then our question, our new question for this week. But we're going to take a break, and we'll do that one separately. I got to go check a thing and get a drink. So sit tight. Here's maybe a sound. I don't know. And then we'll be back with that. Okay, we're back. I don't know if there was a sound there or what, but we are here. Also, I figured out what was going on with the next fan, the noise. It was empty. So it whines when it's empty, I guess, like a lot of people do. So there we go. I refilled it. Now it's a little cooler. Well, imagine that. You fill it. The point, if you don't know what a next fan is, by the way, I think I've talked about this. I will hype this forever because this is great. Many thanks to Ben Beck for the shout out here for recommending the product because it has been a lifesaver. It's been an absolute lifesaver down here. It's a portable air conditioner where it's, you know, it's a little, I mean, you can use it as a fan also, obviously, but you pour water in the top and it cools you down like a little AC, and then the water runs out and then it whines and you refill it, and it's great. I got it for like $40. It was awesome. So awesome. So if you, the downside is you got to sit really close to it, which as I'm working, like it's right on my desk. So I am sitting close enough where I'm going to get the full effect of it. Like you couldn't sit, like you couldn't have it on your table and then sit on the couch and feel it. It's not going to reach that far. But if you're working at your desk and you got to need a little cool air on you and you don't have room for a fan in the room or whatever, you fire this guy up and it's really great. I'm a big fan. Thank you, Ben. So there you go. So I figured it out. It was empty and now it shouldn't whine until, I don't know, tomorrow, I guess. But anyway, there we go. Did you need to know that? Maybe you wanted to know. Maybe you heard the whining or you heard me complaining about it if I didn't cut that out. And you wanted to know, you wanted a resolution. All right? All right. There we go. There we go. So we do have a question for this week about movies once again. I did not plan to do two movie questions in a row, but I thought, I'm like, hey, you know what? Why not? Let's do this. And what we're going to do also is, so last week we did your favorite movie score and we played clips. And so this week, the question's about movies that you've never seen. And so I'm going to play clips from those scores, those themes as well. So more clips. Again, if you want me to feature a favorite of yours that we didn't this week or last week, you let me know, and we will do our best. All right? All right, great. Again, I can only play, you know, 15, 20 seconds of each one because I don't want to get sued. Okay? Okay? All right. All right, great. So update from last week, though. We got a couple. First of all, Lockjaw responded. So I said last week when Lockjaw picked a Lord of the Rings track as his favorite, but then he called the Superman score or the Superman theme the greatest movie theme ever. And so I was like, hey, that seems a little weird. So he responded, thank you, my friend. He said, I picked Lord of the Rings for best movie score because to me, movie score is the score on the whole, not just a particular theme. The score in Lord of the Rings is the best score, no contest, because the music is just as integral in painting the scenes slash telling the story as the visuals, and is just freaking beautiful all the way through. There are dozens of great tracks and moments in the score. Superman is an amazing singular music theme, and I do actually like a lot of the other score. But on the whole, the movie score falls short of Lord of the Rings. There you go. Thank you, my friend. First of all, for listening to the show. No, I'm sorry. First of all, for contributing. Second of all, for actually listening. And third, for paying enough attention to answer the question. So thank you for that. Also, can we shout out MAG real quick while we're shouting out people for listening? Because every week, so I post the show question several places, and every week MAG will usually respond with an answer of some sort. But then he'll listen to the show, and he'll have a compliment about the music that we play. And I think like that is one of the best things that anybody could do for the show. It's like, hey, you know, I listened this week, man, proper, that band is great. You know, whoever I played the week before, I don't even remember anymore. But I'm sure that MAG will dig some Cherie Amour. And if not, well, that's okay too. Not everything is for everybody, but quick shout out there as well. And shout out to Maggie, who also, well, got her sister involved, which we're going to talk about in a second. But also dug the track from Proper last week as well. So there you go. Proper, you got two new fans from me. You're welcome. They're not listening. So anyway, thank you, Lockjaw. Shout out MAG. I think MAG's got one on here as well. So we'll get to that. Maybe not. I don't remember. But anyway, Maggie said last week that, or she said the other day to me that she forgot to mention or forgot to recommend Duel of the Fates from The Phantom Menace for her niece. So we got that. Don't worry. Fun fact. Many years ago, I was, this had to be 2012, and I was walking home from Jill's house or from somebody's house. It was late at night, and I see Bump and I see Dennis, their neighbors, and I'm on a blind note, so I'm like, I see them outside, and they're messing around with lightsabers, and I'm like, okay, well, let's see what's going on. I'm walking by, I can't avoid them, not that I would, but I walk up like, hey, what's going on, guys? What's happening? I'm like, oh, we're going to have a lightsaber fight, and, you know, we're in our 20s at this point, and again, it's like 10:30, 11 o'clock at night, and so They decided to go at it, and I'm like, dude, this could be fun. So I start filming. Maybe they asked me to film. I don't remember. But I start filming, and if it's still on YouTube, I'm going to post it in the show notes or at the website, wherever. I'm going to share it at some point. And I used the Duel of the Fates music for the video. I was I'm still not good at video editing, but I'm pretty proud of that because I feel like I cut it at just the right time, and the music swelled at the right spot. But I used Duel of the Fates for the lightsaber battle that I filmed many years ago on the middle of the block at 10:30 at night or something. I know I have that somewhere. I'm going to find it and I'm going to share it. So thank you. You didn't know this, Maggie, that you were going to lead to that little anecdote, but I appreciate it all the same. And that's a pretty banging track too. As much as the prequels are meh, let's just leave it there. I think we talked about the prequels on the show a couple weeks ago, but we're not going to dump. That's a whole different episode of the show. If we ever want to review movies or whatever, that's a whole different thing, but the music is great. And Darth Maul, the double lightsaber, man, that thing is awesome. Anyway, are those the two good things from Phantom Menace, Pat? Maybe, I don't know. You'd have to ask somebody else, I guess. Or, well, to me, probably, but, the pod racing is fun. But anyway, again, that's a different story. All right, so KG is Maggie's sister. Wow, Pat, you don't know her name? No, actually, I don't. And her Instagram says KG, so that's what we use. I don't know her in real life is what I mean. And so I go by what I have. So KG said, so Maggie texted her sister last week. Maybe it was late. I got it after I recorded the show. And so we couldn't include it last week, so that's my bad. or her. I don't know who's bad, whose fault it is. It doesn't matter because I'm going to do it anyway. So she nominated the unicorn theme from the movie Legend. Now, I've never even heard of this, but I guess I'm going to have to check it out. But this theme, I have to say, it's pretty sick. So thank you, KG, for that. I enjoyed that. That's good. That was really good. And like, she recommended a bunch of others like from the movie, and I'm not going to play them all, but I did like that one, and that was really fun. And I guess I'll have to check out Legend. I don't know. I don't have time to watch movies. We've talked about this, but I'll try. Also, Maggie added to hers, and like I said, with something like this, guys, I get to play clips. Let's do it. She said, I almost got the right part of the Titanic track from last week, but then she added this part from Hard to Starboard, also from Titanic. So there's that. And again, I've seen Titanic maybe once, and I don't remember. There's a scene I do remember, but come on, I was 11 when it came out, or 12 or whatever. Give me a break here. Okay. So that was fun. Maggie also said, and there's a story to this one, which I'm not going to tell you till after, because I don't want to ruin it. So she said, there's a beautiful motif from Pride and Prejudice, the movie in 2005, which of course I've never seen, where she's gazing over the moors. And so I want to play that for you. It is called, do we have the name of the track? I think it's called Liz on Top of the World. Let me see. I'm going to look this up and we're going to see if we get it right. I think it's called Liz on Top of the World. I just put Pride and Prejudice. All right. Anyway, here it is, really a beautiful piece. So hear that and then you will get a story. But here it is. That's lovely, right? Isn't that wonderful? And you're going to be happy if you've never heard it before, if you haven't heard it in a while, and you're like, oh man, it's so nice. You're going to be happy I didn't tell you the story first. So Maggie said, I'm going to read her whole thing. There's a beautiful motif from Pride and Prejudice where she's gazing over the moors, during which my husband farted so violently, I thought he f***ed himself into a hole in the couch. So I want you... So I want you to rewind the show about 30 seconds. I want you to now imagine, listen to that clip again. I'm not going to put it in twice. But damn it.
That's what she said. Woo!
Thank you, Bender. Listen to that clip again. And I want you to imagine that at some point during that beautiful piece of music, that little snippet that I'm able to play without being sued, I want you to imagine that Maggie is sitting on the couch with her husband and he lets one rip that's so violent, so strong that Maggie was deeply concerned for his well-being. I have to tell you, I was listening to, once I figured out the right song, because I'm an idiot, but I thought it was a different one, but I got the right song and I'm listening to it. And I listened to it the first time to get the right clip. And then I pulled it out. And then I'm sitting here cracking up to myself, mentally inserting violent farts to the song to where he might have unleashed. And then to great concern from his wife. He did give me permission to tell that story, by the way. So thank you, Jay, for that. And I hope you're okay. I hope this, like, was this like 2 weeks ago or like 5 years ago? I kind of have to know when this happened. I don't know why that's going to make it funnier or not to me. It's going to be funny no matter what. But I think a little timeline would help out for me and maybe the listener as well. Okay, so there are your updates from last week. More movie scores. Don't worry, we got more coming. Don't you worry. Because again, one of the most fun episodes I've done and one that got the most feedback in a while. So thank you sincerely for that. And so our question for this week, which I didn't plan again 2 weeks in a row, but it works out. Which movie that you've never seen makes people say, "You've never seen that?" And there are a lot of big ones on here. There are. Kenny says, Return of the King. Yeah, and so I was going through this yesterday, and I asked Jill, hey, because she's a big Lord of the Rings fan. And so I said, hey, what's your favorite track? Do you have one from Return of the King? And she's like, I don't know what the things are called. And she's like, oh, why that one? I said, well, that's what Kenny said when I said movie you haven't seen. And so she wanted to know if he had seen the other ones. And he said, yes. So I guess for some reason he tapped out after the second one. I don't know. I didn't even make it through The Hobbit. I guess I should have started with Fellowship. I don't know. But anyway, did we play the track? We'll do it now. Kenny says Return of the King. Might be awkward up top if we already gave that little layout there, but it'll be fine. I think we found a good piece of music there. I liked it. Michelle says, Ghostbusters. That's going to sound weird, but it's going to be fine. Michelle, watch Ghostbusters. I'm sure many people have told you during your life to watch Ghostbusters. Well, you can add me to the list. Watch Ghostbusters. The first one. Don't worry about the other ones. Watch the first one. I'm going to give you, you know what, Michelle? You're getting homework. Watch the first one from 80, what year did it come out? 86, 87? I don't know. And then watch the Lady Ghostbusters that came out in like 2011 or 12 with Kristen Wiig, Melissa McCarthy, Leslie Jones. Who else was in that movie? Well, Chris Hemsworth. Who was the other? I forget. Anyway, a lot of people kind of dumped on Lady Ghostbusters. I found it delightful. I thought it was wonderful. And it didn't... it ruined Ghostbusters. Watching that movie should not ruin the original in any way. Just go watch the original again. You'll be fine, I promise. So Michelle, watch two movies. I don't, like, she's gonna have time. Watch the first Ghostbusters from the 80s, and then watch the Lady Ghostbusters from 2011 or 12. Both are wonderful, and then people will stop telling you to watch Ghostbusters. So really, it's a win for you and for everyone. So there you go. All right, let's see. Prime Birds, we played his music on the show a few weeks ago or months ago. Time means nothing. But he says, got absolutely annihilated at a recent family gathering for admitting I'd never seen Jurassic Park. First of all, my friend, thank you for contributing. Second of all, don't admit that. Why would you do that? That's dumb on your part. Third, go watch Jurassic Park. Just do it. It's great. And fourth, I think you listened last week and you must have said, wow, we got to give Pat another chance to play Jurassic Park music. So we're going to do that. Because again, that's my favorite one, I think. And I get to play a different part. I said last week, there are like two or three parts I could have used. And now we get to play two of them. So very excited about that. Thank you. And go watch Jurassic Park. It's great. It is great. I love that movie so much. Jen says, Dirty Dancing. Well, you know what? First of all, I can see how that movie is not for everyone. Or like you see a trailer or see it on TV. You're like, what's this crap? And then you change it because you're like, I don't care. But I can also see, because I've seen it and I do like it, I can also see where people would be like, you've never seen it? It's a great movie. Bah, 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 bah. And, you know, people do that. But that's a good pick. I like that as a pick and that I get to play this. and hopefully not get sued. So there you go. Thank you, Jen. Maggie says, anything my husband loves. And so I said, hey, can we get him to chime in? And Jay chimed in that she's never seen The Shawshank Redemption. And I have a confession. I've never seen it either. I have it because somebody said, hey, you should watch it. And I don't have time now. So I should have watched it in 2020 is really what I should have done. But I was busy making an album. So so I had to, you know, my time was allocated elsewhere. And now who knows? I got to wait till the kid goes to school, I guess, to watch all these movies. And if I was a petty person, which at times I am, I would point out that Jay misspelled redemption when he was calling out his wife on my Facebook post. But I'm not that kind of guy. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to call out Jay for misspelling redemption. I won't do it. I won't. You can do it. You can say, ha ha, Jay, you misspelled the word redemption. But I'm not going to do it. I won't. I refuse because that's not the kind of guy I am. I'm not going to do it. But thank you, Jay, for the recommendation. And I will get on it. At some point. You'll probably watch it with Maggie before me. But I'm saying it's on my list as well. So we'll try. Maggie then chimed in with her own, or added a list of movies that she said she hadn't seen. She has seen these all now. But she said she hasn't seen these movies, and her husband stone-faced her. She said Forrest Gump, Sling Blade, Billy Madison, Happy Gilmore, Grandma's Boy, Avatar, and Wolf of Wall Street. I have seen all of those except Sling Blade and Avatar. I don't have scores for all those, by the way. That's too much. Forrest Gump, I don't love it as much as everybody else. Billy Madison and Happy Gilmore are staples in this house. Love it. Grandma's Boy, shout out Doug. I saw once, enjoyed it. Don't remember much about it, but it is funny. I remember enjoying it. I remember thinking it was funny. Never saw Avatar, don't care. And Wolf of Wall Street, I will say, I don't think my review of, or my rebuke, I guess, of Wolf of Wall Street is fair, because I watched it while I was writhing in pain with a kidney stone. And so it just seemed to go on forever. It did have Margot Robbie and, you know, so that was good. I thought the movie was good. It just seemed to drag on forever, maybe because I was, again, writhing in pain with a kidney stone. And so that's not very fair. But also, I don't have 3 hours to watch the movie again. So I think we're going to chalk that up to being, it was okay. I liked it, I guess. It just seemed to go on forever and ever. And it just, I don't know. Maybe that was me being in a lot of pain. You know what? How long is, I'm going to look this up. Maybe we're both right. Maybe it seemed to go on forever because I was in pain. And also, it did last forever. So let me see. Can we get runtime? Do they have runtime on Wikipedia? Come on, don't let me down. Don't let me down. 3 hours. That's a long movie. All right. There you go. Thank you, Maggie, for all those. Let's see. Tom says Titanic. Do we have another one? Actually, you know what? Damn it. I was supposed to save one of those. Do we have another one from Titanic? Hold on. Maybe I grabbed another one. Let's see. Hard to Starboard. And... sorry, Tom. Nope, didn't get. We already used one. We used two from Titanic, but Tom says, that's a movie where people are like, yeah, of course I've seen Titanic. And then when you don't, it's like, really? And people get mad. I understand. I get that. Thanks, buddy. Amber says, for a while, it was Star Wars. I eventually watched it. Only the one, though, I can't read, with Luke, I Am Your Father. So I still haven't watched the rest. And fun fact, I know everyone knows this. It's a Mandela effect. He doesn't say, Luke, I am your father. He says this.
No, I am your father.
No. It's not true.
And then there we go. Could I have played some more music from Star Wars? Yeah, but there's some score in there. There's some instrument. There's some fun stuff in there with the iconic line, which was not the original, right? Everybody knows this. I'm not going to talk about it. But thank you, Amber. I think you're good, actually. I really do. Like, you've only seen Empire Strikes Back. I think you're actually fine. If you don't, let me see. If you don't like Star Wars that much, like if you don't care and you only want to see one, I think Empire Strikes Back is the one. Right? So, Amber, I think you're fine. Thank you for that. I appreciate it. Meg says, Avatar, the blue people won. Neither of them. No desire either. Yeah, I don't. Do we have some Avatar music? One, you know what? Let's find some. I don't want to see those movies either. I don't care. They don't. They mean nothing to me. Everyone says, "Oh, you got to watch Brett." And what's it about? I don't care. I really like. You start explaining it, and I'm already out. I don't care. But I'm sure the music is great because movie music is usually great. So there we go. Thanks, Meg. Don't watch it. Don't do it. Stay strong. Damn it. You probably are not being pressured that much. But anyway, thank you very much. MAG, see, I knew we'd come back. Says, any recent Star Wars? I feel like we said this last week when it took 13 or 14 tracks to get to Star Wars. Are we over it? Or not we, like, I mean, like, collectively. Are you still getting grief for not seeing a recent Star Wars movie? Or is it like, oh, you should see this movie? I'm not discounting your experience. I'm trying to figure out where in the consciousness Star Wars lies right now. Because they have the TV shows, which people enjoy. I've not seen any of them. And the new movies, right? The newer movies, right? But are people like, because if you say, oh, I've never seen, you know, the original trilogy, people freak out about that. But are people still kind of getting mad at you for not seeing the latest trilogy? I wonder. Let me know. I know that you're going to listen, so I'd like to know. Gertner says, I've never seen any Star Wars movie, any Indiana Jones movie, any Die Hard, any Batman movie, post-Batman Forever, or whatever the one that had Arnold as Mr. Freeze and Jim Carrey as the Riddler. Well, what I could have done if I really had time to put in the work is gotten some music from all of those, even though we already played two of them. But instead, I'll give you this.
Can you feel it coming? The icy cold of space. Ah.
And yeah, Gertner did clarify that Batman and Robin was the last Batman he'd seen, and he did not enjoy it. So, I mean, like, if that was the one that I had seen, I'd be like, oh, another Batman? It might be another crappy one like that. Ugh. You know, I get it. My wife loves that movie, but I mean, whatever. It's Batman. The suit has nipples. It's something else. Just watch the animated series. You'll be fine. Lockjaw says Jaws. Really? Wow. Well, here it is. I don't know why I'm shocked about that one more than the others. I just feel like that, like everyone at some point has given in, not given in, but everyone, that's my water bottle, by the way, making that noise. Everyone at some point has just sat down to watch Jaws, because everyone's like, oh man, Jaws, shark, man, need a bigger boat, right? Maybe not. Well, apparently not, Lockjaw. Well, not apparently, definitely not. Lockjaw has not seen it. But thanks, buddy. I appreciate your input as always. Destor says, Casablanca. I bought it last week, though, so that'll change soon. So here we go. And he did come back to update, by the way, that he has seen the movie. And did he enjoy it? I don't know. Should we look it up to try to find his answer real quick? Let me see. Oh, he said he watched it. And it was good for the genre, whatever that means. I've never seen it. I couldn't tell you a thing about it. I've never seen Gone with the Wind either. People freak out about that. But yeah, there you go. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it, I guess, in some way. If good for the genre means you like the movie, that works. No, I get it. I know what he means. I know what he means. Oh, man. I don't have a clip for this, but I have to shout out our friend Poop from Wiener Dude with maybe my favorite username of all time. Name a movie, chances are I've seen it. And he threw in a salute. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate you, man. Have a good day. I know. Did I have to read that? No, but I like to read comments that I get if I can. Dr. A says, for the longest time, it was Forrest Gump, but now it's probably Field of Dreams. I like Field of Dreams. I've been to Field of Dreams. It's a real place. I do want to see a game there. I would like, because now that Major League Baseball does the Field of Dreams game, I would like to go see a game there. But it was cool, man. I got to go there when I was like 8. It was fun. It's pretty neat. The corn wasn't up. It was like April. So that sucked. So the corn wasn't up. But, and my mom tried to knock on the door for Kevin Costner, and they said no. Whoever was there said no. And so that sucked. But it's all good, man. You watch it whenever you want. Whenever you want. Did you like Forrest Gump, by the way? When you finally watched it, did you like it? I thought it was okay. All right. Anyway, thanks, buddy. Mallory says the Rocky series, all of them. That's fair. You're not expected to watch those. That's a guy thing, right? It's a weird thing to say. But like if I said to Jill, hey, have you seen a Rocky movie? And she says, no. I'm not going to be like, what do you mean you've never seen Rocky? Because like, who cares, first of all? But if I say, oh, I've only seen like one or two of them, people would probably be like, dude, what are you doing? Watch Rocky. Brr. I've seen the first one. And the other ones I think I've only seen on TV. So really, I've only seen the first one. Doesn't really count. I've said before on the show, if the only time you've seen a movie is on TV, you haven't seen it because it's edited, it's cut down, you miss stuff. It's all like you haven't seen the movie as intended if you've only seen it on TV. So if you've seen the movie and then you watch it on TV later and you realize they cut out a scene, that's different, right? Or whatever, right? So like if you're just watching it, they're like, oh yeah, Back to the Future, boom, we'll put that on. You know, I've seen those movies plenty of times, so. Anyway, thank you, Mallory. Smelly Meatball says, Goodfellas. Don't think I've ever seen it. And any potential memories are probably from The Godfather instead. Well, here's Goodfellas. And fun fact, I've never seen Goodfellas either. Nope, it's on the list. People have told me about it for years that I should watch it. I've never seen it. I have no frame of reference for it. It's on the list. I'll try. I will try. thanks, buddy. I hope if you want to go see it, I hope you see it soon. Go see it like it's in theaters. If you want to watch it, I hope you watch it soon. Thanks, man. Guru DeWay says, none of the Indiana Jones movies, and I'm going to keep it that way. I love the conviction. I love it. We don't need another clip. We're good. I did it. No, I like the conviction, though, man. Like, if people are bothering you about seeing Indiana Jones or, you know, The Godfather or whatever, if people are bugging you and you're like, you know what? After all this time, screw it. I don't want to watch them anyway. So go ahead, man. I like that. Good stuff. Thank you. Splaya. I don't know how to read. Says any of the bad, somebody's going to hear this and go, you idiot, it's obviously, and I don't know which one it is. Any of the Back to the Future movies, wow, and like on purpose, or just like you never watched it and now it's like, eh, who cares, right? Because if you don't want to watch them, like that's different, right? I mean, and that's fine too, like you're allowed to not want to see movies or whatever, like that's okay, but I don't know, I feel like Back to the Future, like you've at least caught some of that at some point, but like. To actively avoid. I like Guru DeWay, though, the suggestion or the conviction of I'm never going to watch them, which I think is great. I like Indiana Jones movies. I think they're good. I haven't seen the latest one, but I like the franchise generally. And I felt that way about Lord of the Rings, where like I'm not going to watch them. She's never going to watch them because everybody was like, oh, you got to see. I'm like, I don't care. I just don't care. But you know what I think I'll do, though, is again, if somebody wants to take the kid for a day, we can watch them all, the first three anyway, so I have an idea of what everyone's talking. And like I said, my wife loves those movies, so I feel like we should try to make some time. I should try to sit down and enjoy those with her. I think that'd be great, because she did watch the Bourne movies with me, so we should probably do that. All right, do we have any more? We have one more from Judge Greg, Amanda, and Brian Amato. Thank you for weighing in. This is also mine. Where people give me the most grief for not seeing this movie, it's The Godfather. yeah, I've never, I don't know. Like, I've heard people talk about it a lot, and, you know, it's a obviously a famous movie. It's a longer movie. I remember when Josh was on the show a couple years ago, when we talked about movies longer than 2 hours, and how I generally, like, if the runtime is more than 2 hours, I'm going to shy away, because I just feel like you should be able to tell your story in less time than that. And it just, like, I don't know. It, like, if I'm going in, and, like, when I saw Avengers or whatever the one was that we saw, I didn't know how long it was. I didn't check. I didn't know, because I was like, all right, we got to see, like, we're going to wrap this, like, phase of the story, so we got to see this movie. We've seen all the rest of them, so now I got to wrap this phase, and now we're, like, two phases behind or something. But I didn't know that it was going to be so long. It didn't feel that long. Like, it kind of breezed through, not in a bad way, but I don't know. I guess now I don't know. Now I'm conscious of it, how long a movie is and how long I do or don't want to sit for something. But I feel like I should watch The Godfather, and I'll let you know if I do. I think I have it somewhere. I think we have it upstairs. Or actually, if it's on DVD, it'd be right down here, because we started a project, by the way, some months ago, because we thought we were going to have to get rid of this big bookcase. This has nothing to do with movies or with movie scores. But we thought we'd have to get rid of this big bookcase we have in our dining room, because it would become a tipping hazard. And that bookcase held a lot of our DVDs. And so we got like a book with a bunch of sleeves in it, so we could get rid of the cases and keep them all in this big binder. And we haven't had time to do that yet. So right now, all of our DVDs are sitting in bags and baskets in the basement, and we're waiting for some time to sit down here. Also, we got to wait for it to cool down. I think that's really, because now at this point, it's really hot. So we got to wait. It's a fall activity. We can sit down here in late October, early November maybe, or maybe early October, I don't know, and sort those and get them all into the thing, and then free up some space down here too. Because that's like I said a few months ago, that is the plan, to free up some space. Anyway, nothing to do with the movies or the movie scores. It has to do with physical movies and us needing time to clean things up. But anyway, I've never seen The Godfather. So there you go. I've never seen Good Will Hunting either. And people give me some grief on that. So those are my two, I guess. I haven't seen a lot of movies. And people are always, not always, but often up in arms about movies I've not seen. And I don't have time. I don't have time. I'll watch TV. I'd rather watch a TV show, if we're being real. So let me know about that, and then I'll add it to my list. And then when I have time, when I'm not super busy, I'll watch it and let you know. I'll review the pilot on the show, and I will let you know. All right? But thank you, everyone, for weighing in on your movies. Maybe can we make it three in a row for the movie questions on the show? I don't know. We're going to try. Maybe we won't. What else could I do? I'm not sure. Anyway, if you have any movies you haven't seen and people get mad about it, or your favorite movie score, let me know, and we will plug them in and talk about them as we go along. All right? All right. Thanks, everyone. Appreciate your answers. And that's about that for the show. Before we go, let me let you know we are in football season. And your game of the week for week one, I got to text my experts. The San Francisco 49ers at the Pittsburgh Steelers. So there you go. Make your pick. If you want to get in to the pick'em, you have until kickoff on Sunday for this game to get in for this week. After that, you'll take a loss for week one and you'll pick up with week two. All right. Again, I pick a game every week through the Super Bowl. Well, the playoff matchups are decided in that, but through the regular season, I pick a game. I send it to you. You pick who you think's going to win. And the person who gets the most correct by the end of the year, playoffs and Super Bowl included, you get to take over a segment of the show because you won. All right? So let me know everywhere at the Melting Pat if you want to get involved, you want your name on the list, and let me know the best way to get in touch with you, and then I'll send you the picks that way. All right? All right. That's all. Break. That was bad. That's better. Maybe not. I don't know. Anyway, we're all done. Thanks for being here. Thank you to Cherie Amour. Their new song, 702, is available now. The album, or the EP, Some Songs EP, coming out October 20 on Equal Vision Records. Go check them out, CherieAmourBand.com. Tell them I sent you, and they'll say, yeah, that guy. Or they won't. I don't know what they'll say. But anyway, there we go. We're good. Oh, God, I hope so. I hope so. We're good to go. Go have fun. All right, this has been an 8 Boiling production. Until next time, my friends, have fun. Be safe. Thank a veteran. Wear your mask, wash your hands, get vaccinated and boosted when you can. And of course, don't do anything I wouldn't do. TheMeltingPath.com for all of my stuff. No G love today because we've been here a bit. But check them out anyway. Philadelphonic.com for more. From them, you're going to hear music from me. From me, I wrote this and made it. I did it. I did that. Me in my apartment in 2015. Will I make it a full song? I don't know. Do you want to help me make it a full song? That sounds great. Let's do that. I'll remember how to play it. Maybe. Or we'll make something new. Let's do that. All right? All right. We're going to go. We are going to go. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day. Have a great week. Have fun doing all the things that you do. And I will talk to you when I talk to you. All right? Thank you. Thank you. I love you. See you later. You've been inside the Melting Pat on the Next Level Network. Go crap open a cold one.